CME Group will launch both one-month and three-month futures contracts based upon the overnight SOFR rate in early May 2018, subject to regulatory review. Background on establishment of the SOFR rate can be found in a separate lesson in this course. This lesson will review the contract structure and pricing mechanics for both SOFR futures contracts. The combination of both one-month and three-month contracts is expected to be complementary by facilitating price discovery at various points of the money market curve. The spreading opportunities against well-established liquidity pools of 30-day Fed funds and three-month Eurodollar futures will assist in developing liquidity in both one-month and three-month contracts based on the overnight SOFR. The one-month SOFR futures contract's final settlement value will be based on the average of the overnight SOFR for that month's time period. The one-month SOFR futures contract construction is nearly identical to the existing 30-day Fed Fund futures contract. Applying the monthly averaging process that is currently used to calculate the final settlement interest rate of the 30-day Fed Funds futures contract, we find that the corresponding final settlement interest rate of hypothetical one-month SOFR futures would have averaged 3.33 basis points lower than the final settlement rates implied by the actual final settlement prices of 30-day Fed Funds futures. The exchange calculation methods, averaging monthly and compounding quarterly, for determining final settlement prices for one-month and three-month SOFR futures are expected to significantly reduce the impact of the volatility potentially observed in the daily overnight SOFR values at quarter end. Comparisons of one-month SOFR futures to 30-day federal funds futures suggest that the heightened volatility of quarter-end SOFR values may have been unique to Q2 and Q3 2016. Now, let's take a look at the one-month contract in more detail. Looking at the one-month contract specifications reveals additional similarities to 30-day Fed funds futures. For example, the basis point value for the one-month SOFR futures contract is 41.67 per contract. SOFR futures will trade IMM index points. The final settlement price will be determined by the arithmetic average of the daily SOFR during the delivery month carried out to the fourth decimal place. The last trading day will be the last exchange business day of the contract delivery month. Now let's take a look at the three-month SOFR contract. The three-month SOFR contract will be similar to the three-month Eurodollar futures contract. The basis point value for the three-month SOFR futures contract is $25 per contract. It will also trade IMM index points. The final settlement prices will be determined by daily compounding of the overnight SOFR rate covering the actual day count for that contract's interval. There is a critical difference between the three-month SOFR futures contract and the three-month Eurodollar futures contract. Three-month SOFR futures contract month naming convention will mirror the well-established convention for three-month Eurodollar futures. The similarities of the applicable cash flow dates are key to understanding the three-month difference in last trading days for identically named contract months. For example, consider two futures contracts. A September Eurodollar futures contract expires two business days prior to the third Wednesday of September, otherwise known as an IMM date. The interest rate interval expressed in the September Eurodollar futures contract covers the three-month period between IMM Wednesday September to IMM Wednesday December. The three-month SOFR futures with a September contract date will expire the first exchange business day preceding the third Wednesday of December. The daily compounding begins on IMM Wednesday, September, and therefore covers the same interest rate interval as September Eurodollar futures. A September three-month SOFR futures has a final settlement the third Wednesday of December. This interest rate interval compares to the same interest rate interval expressed by a September expiration of a Eurodollar futures contract. Between these two contracts, September three-month SOFR and September Eurodollar, the interval of interest rate exposure is essentially the same. It will be useful to understand the pricing mechanism of the three-month SOFR futures contract. The exchange will apply daily compounding between quarterly IMM dates for the purpose of determining final settlement prices of expiring three-month SOFR futures. The daily compounding convention will be consistent with and familiar to users of standard US dollar overnight index swaps, for which the swap's floating rate leg is based on the business day compounded effective Fed funds rate, or EFFR. The impact upon the future's final settlement price of any potential quarter-end volatility in daily SOFR values would be muted by the daily compounding process. Comparisons of the three-month SOFR rates to the three-month OIS and USD ICE LIBOR are relevant due to the expected application of floating rate legs for interest rate swaps and spreading of the three-month Eurodollar and SOFR futures. Applying the three-year SOFR time series that begins on August 22, 2014, we developed a rolling three-month time series for daily estimates of compounded three-month SOFR and comparisons to three-month EFFR OIS and three-month USD ICE LIBOR. When comparing a three-month compounded SOFR with similar intervals of the EFFR and three-month USD ICE LIBOR, you can see high levels of correlation. SOFR futures will allow for enhanced price discovery and risk management of short-term interest rate products. Market participants should consult the product specifications for both the one-month and three-month SOFR futures contracts for all details. Additionally, more information can be found on cmegroup.com/SOFR.